Hi everyone, good morning. Let me welcome you all for today's sessions of Z Transform, which is coming under VTU, under Module 5, and fourth semester EC students are studying. Now, this is a continuation sessions of my previous four sessions, right, where we discussed till now about Z transform and its applications and its comparisons with other transforms and the Z transform equations, how to find Z transform for simple problems, simple signals, and then complex signals, and then we went for properties. There we studied the last sessions, we studied four properties: linearity property, time shifting property, scaling in Z domain property, and time reversals properties. Today in these sessions, we will see other two important properties, which is very, very important actually: convolutions property and differentiations in Z domain property. Here, all these properties, right, are useful in analyzing, right, signals x of n, discrete time signals, very, very efficiently. And this is very, very useful actually. All this property gives flexibility and efficiency to study signals processing very efficiently. And also, right, it is useful in next semesters to study digital signal processing, where we will study these signals only in time domain and frequency domain only. Now, this saves these two properties. If I take this, very, very right, significance of these two properties is that the convolutions property is, it saves time and it increases the speed of processing, right, to the processors to do real time projects. Now, let me see how exactly this is useful, and let us see the statement and right, proof also, right. Now let me see first convolutions property. This is a very, very important property even in now also, in signal processing also, next DSP also. Now let me first write the statement. What this statement says: take two signals x1n and x2n, right? Take Z transform of x1n, which will give x1z as Z transform. Z transform of second sequence will give x2z as Z transforms. Then prove that the linear convolutions of these signals, linear convolutions of x1n, linear convolutions with x2n. This is not into, this is linear convolutions actually. Z transform of linear convolutions of x1n and x2n gives you the right side, the RHS, as multiplications of two sequences in Z domain. That is x1z into, this is into, multiplication this is, into x2z. Then what is the significance with R was at least, R1 belongs to R. Significance of this is, right, we might have seen already, this linear convolutions of two signals, x1n, x2n, in module 2, I do in next sessions, when I take up LTI systems, is almost, to calculate linear convolutions of two signals x1 and x2n, you need at least half a page or one page to get way of it. What is that? There are n methods. One is tabular column methods, the other is equations method, the other is linear convolutions graph, which we will see later. That will take minimum half page to get the output. Half page or one page to get out. Now, if you take Z transform of that linear convolution itself in the right side, in the Z transform, it is equivalent to, one page equivalent to, just one word multiplication. That is x1z and x2z multiplication. That means one page work, processing work, is being reduced by just one word. Right? That means just take x1z, Z transform of first, Z transform of second, you know it, multiply that. That saves time. That increases speed. Half a page work is reduced by one word, and that increases the speed of processing, And definitely today's processings are image processing or multi-processing or a multi-video or audio, whatever you take, there thousand times you want to do this linear convolutions only. Then each time it is reduced by one page, is reduced by one word only. That's how we increase processing, and we have seen wonderful applications through a Zoom now. Right? Maybe 1,000 lakhs of people are using Zoom by using all this property. This is one such property, convolution property. Now this is the statement. Now proof is very, very simple and easy. Let's go for this proof. First is, let me use of this linear convolutions property one. Right? What is that? We know that convolutions of linear convolutions of two signals is x1n and into, is not into. Linear convolution symbol is into. Convolutions of x1n into x2n is given by the standard formula. Right? Summations k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x1k into x2 of minus n minus k, which is in the form of shifted impulse. Shifted impulse. This is standard formula, which is you will study it in second module. When I take up next sessions, you wait for it. I will prove these equations only. Right now, let me use this linear convolution equation. That's all. Now, go to the left hand side now. Right? Take a equation. So we know this second line. We know that Z transform equations for any sequence Z of X of n, like any other properties. Z of X of n is equal to xz is equal to formula n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of n into z power minus n. Call this also a standard formula. Now substitute in this x of n that formula, that LHS. What is that? What is that LHS? LHS is x1n convolutions of x2n. Just substitute. Later on, this is only maths. Z transform of x1n convolutions of x2n is equal to, write that x of n plus this x1n into x2n. That is, n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity. X of n is nothing but that x1n into, that is, convolutions of x2n z power minus n formula. Now, substitute this x1n into linear convolution of x2n from your linear convolution equation, which you know here. Call this as equation number 1. Substitute from this here. What is x1n into convolutions of x2n? That is nothing but k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x1k x2 of n minus k from equation 1. The rest is n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity z to the power minus. Then only math I am doing here. Right? Interchange this this summations order. This you write it first and this you write it later. Interchange the order of summations. What you get is summations k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity. Take it outside. Right? Summation LHS is equal to summations k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x1k into summations n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x2 of n minus k. This I am writing later, that's all. X2 of n minus k into z power minus n, and this summations I am writing later. Here. Right? Here. Now, go to as usual, go for substitution, sir, changing summations, these summations, right, like any other summations. Substitute n minus k, this n minus k as l. Then summation changes from summations n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity as l is equal to plus infinity to minus infinity. That is all here, like any other properties in my previous sessions. Now what is that? Substitute n minus k is equal to l. Substitute when n is equal to minus infinity. When n is equal to minus infinity, what happens? L is equal to minus infinity minus k, which is nothing but l is equal to minus infinity. Therefore, your lower summation is k is equal to minus infinity 2. Then similarly, when n is equal to plus infinity, then l is equal to infinity minus k, which is equal to plus infinity. That is what this. Now, your LHS is equal to summations k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x1k into this summations n is equal to this new limits minus infinity to plus infinity, minus infinity to plus infinity x2 of, what is n minus k? N minus k is nothing but l. Substitute here. Then z power minus, what is n? N is nothing but n is equal to l plus k. That I am substituting, l plus k. Now split this term, that's all. Split this term, and then what will get is, now see, LHS is equal to summation k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x1k. Z power minus k, take out this minus k first. Z power minus k, this is splitted as into z power minus n. z power minus k you bring it to this side, this summation, z power minus n you bring it to this summation. That's what I am doing. See that? Z power minus k I am take it out from there, I am putting here. Summation z is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x2k into z power minus n I am putting it for second. Now what is this? This whole thing is nothing but x1z. See this standard formula. K is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x1k z power minus k, which is nothing but x1z. Similarly, second term is x2z, which is equal to RHS, hence the problem. LHS is equal to summations right side is equal to multiplications of two z sequence z transform x1z into x2z. That is RHS. What is this? Let me repeat in two lines now. First, write the property. This is the statement, two sequences, two z sequences. Then z transform of linear convolutions of two sequences is equal to multiplications of two sequences in z. That is equivalent to only one word, x1z, x2z. How to prove this? First, you write this first line. As we know that linear convolutions of any two sequences is given by shifted impulses by using the standard equation, that is k is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x1k x2 of n minus k, which is in second module dealt in LTI. Let us see now later. Now write this standard equations, z transform of any general equation x of n as these equations. Now substitute LHS, z transform of what is asked. LHS is x1n into x2n, that is linear convolution. Is equal to substitute here in here. Now then afterwards write these linear convolutions from equation 1, substitute here. Then split this, change the order of summations. Then k summations comes first, n summations goes next. Then substitute n minus k as l, interchange, then summations changes to n to l, then this is given inside. Therefore, right side is equal to k is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x1k, l is equal to minus infinity plus 2 infinity x2n into z power minus k into z power minus n. Split this and substitute. You will get 1 z power minus k here, z power minus l here. This is nothing but x1z into x2z, which is nothing but the convolutions property. Similarly, last property, one more very interesting property is differentiations in z-domain property, which says what the statement. This is also very, very important. First line is z transform of any sequence x of n is x of z with r was r. Z transform of any sequence, that sequence multiplied by n. For example, let's say x of n multiply with n, maybe 100, 1000. In an image, it may be 1000 times. Then is equivalent to right side in z domain derivative of d of xz. This is x of z is there now. Derivative of xz by dz into minus z, which is what the name. See this name of this property, differentiation in z domain. That's what I am doing. Right, this is the statement. This is very, very useful in image processing. When your image is having more than one signal, maybe 1000 into x of n. Nowadays, that's what image signals are, image processing are, or multiprocessing is a business, is there where we are living. Therefore, this property, then whenever such images, 1000 images, 1000 signals are there, then always it is analyzed using this z transform. Right side, it is equivalent to derivative of xz with respect to dz into minus z. This is the significance. Now, proof is very, very easy. Right, first line as it is, z transform of x of n is equal to x of z, n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of n into z power minus n, standard equation. Then differentiate this equation with respect to z, because dz we want, dx of z with respect to dz we want. See this RHS and differentiate both sides. Therefore, your right hand side is equal to, next line is derivative of dxz by dz is equal to this dxz by dz is equal to differentiate this with respect to z. What will happen? It is summation n is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of n. This is same. Now, derivative of z power minus n with respect to dz is minus n into derivative of dz to the power z to the power minus n minus 1. That's what I am writing. Minus n into z power minus n minus 1. Now it is over. Take out this minus n outside. Into summation z is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, minus infinity to plus infinity into nxn. n x n into z power minus n into z power minus 1. This is treated as. Why? Because I want answer. Z power minus n I want. Therefore, next line is minus n x n, you write in one place, and then this z inverse is there now, that comes down. It is nothing but 1 by z. That 1 by z I am writing here. This minus n already is there. Into n x n I want in a groups n x n, z power minus n. Why? Because is, see this LHS, RHS, see this, what is the term I want? N x n I want. Z transform of n x n I want. That's why I am writing n x n combinations in one group. Then afterwards, last line is, bring this z that side, minus 1 also that side. This becomes minus z is goes this side, minus z, derivative of x dx z by dz is equal to right side is equal to n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity n x n into z power minus n. Now it is over. This is nothing but standard equation. Any z transform equation, z of x of n is nothing but summation n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of n z power minus n. This is of this form. Now see this. This can be written as now. So in place of x n, I am having n x n. Therefore, this can be written as z transform of n x n. That's what this. Z transform of n x n. In place of x of n x n, I am having. This is nothing but z transform of n x n left side is equal to right side is same. Minus z derivative of dx z by dz. Ends the problem. What is this? Only within two lines you can finish off this property. First write the statement as it is, x of n, x of z, x of n into n times is equal to right side, it is differentiations of dz, dx of z versus dz. Now proof is, write first line as it is, just differentiate the both sides by with respect to z, that's all. Derivative of dx by dz, that's what I am doing. Dx z by dz is equal to right side also differentiate with respect to dz. Then your this formula is same. Here this is minus n z to the power minus n minus 1. Split this. Then finally group this nxn because left side it is there. Then z power minus n comes down 1 by z. Then take this to left side. This only math is equal to summation n is equal to minus n plus nxn into z power minus n, which is nothing but standard equation. That is nothing but z transform of nxn, which is nothing but z transform of nxn is equal to derivative minus z derivative of dx z by dz, hence the property. This way, in this way, these two properties in case of z domain, z transform is very, very useful to process any signals of today, image processing or multi-processing or zoom, you just take it out. These properties gives flexibility to analyze any signals and without error. See that now zoom we are all using. See that without error, without any problem, we are receiving also, we are sending also. Because of, and it is easy to analyze quickly, right? That's all. I hope I am clear in this session, sir. Next session, sir, let me take the properties of, using these properties, all these properties, it seems, how to solve the problems, the transform problems. We'll see that. That is also very interesting. In the maybe next sessions, let me do that. Next sessions. Till that, thank you. Thank you very much. Here.